Hey, what up, y'all? Colby, Arrowhead Bison. Haven't seen this guy in a while. Talked about him a little bit. But let's get some good close-ups of this dude. The man himself, Tex.
The old pure-blood Texas Longhorn.
Their condition has definitely improved after we opened up that pasture. So, that dude is just so mean. Oh my goodness. And this is why I stand at least 10 feet back from this dude. He's just kind of a bully. Aren't ya? Aren't ya, Tex? You're just kind of a bully. And here we got his lady, Cinnamon. What's up, Cinnamon? Man, look at all those flies. It's almost mid-October and we still got really warm weather and flies are still out. But hey, it's Oklahoma, whatever. And then we got Bruno on the right and we got Chisholm on the left. You're just looking like your daddy, aren't you? You just got a little more white right around your nose. But you got that little white patch, just like,
oh, wait, watch out, dude. Come on, man.
Wow. Does that feel good? Oh yeah? Is that a warning? Should I step back? Oh, hi Bruno. Hi, buddy. Man, them horns about straight as an arrow, Bruno. And there she is. We're out here on the pasture, south pasture, west side of the pasture, and got a photo session going on. That is Gunner and Haley. So congrats to them. Engagement photos. And the herd has been doing great. So, oh yeah, that was a good one. So yeah, exciting times. So, but it's a good chance for me to give them treats. I gave them apples tonight. And big shout out to Conscious Community Co-op for supplying us with a heavily discounted apple price. And gave us a really good deal on like 60 pounds of apples. So they got 20 pounds tonight. No, 40. I'm sorry. I got 120 pounds. That's what it was. 120 pounds. Gave them 40 pounds tonight. But, yeah, here we go. So they're doing really well, and they got a lot of really cool photos of the bison in the background. So, yeah, but it's also a chance for me, obviously, to check on the herd. So I've been with them quite a bit this week, and everyone's doing really well. So, yeah, can't complain at all. Old black feather always hanging out in the back. Our red dog is not red anymore. But really happy with that calf's progression. She's looking really good. And there's our big boy. I have decided I'm going to start hanging them probably this next week. At least starting out with one bell every 5 days or so. Stella's always going to hold a special place. She is the only heifer we've ever kept as a breeder you know, like the only calf we've ever kept out of our herd. Like she was born here, and she's the only one we've ever kept as a breeder. So hopefully she is pregnant right now and we'll drop a calf next year, because I think she hit her breeding maturity this year, this breeding season. So good times. Okay, well, got ourselves a little predicament here on a gorgeous Monday morning. Should be working my day job, good old Highline, but you know, sometimes, just like what happened a few weeks ago, you look out the window and you see something you shouldn't see. Well, I saw an animal. I saw all the bison on the west part of the south pasture, the west part of the south 40, and I saw one lone animal kind of by the gate where they cross on the east part of the south 40. Well, upon further inspection, I kept looking. I was about to get my spotting scope out to see who it was. I saw three other animals pop up, and they were not bison. They were our longhorns. Yee! Not supposed to be in the south pasture. Okay. So, same problem that I posted a couple weeks ago. They're jumping that low spot because I haven't fixed it yet. So, right now, I shut the gate, and I'm just going to try to keep them on the east part of the South 40 for today, so that I can go to work, do my thing, get back, and bait them with some cubes or something to try to get back into their pasture. Not really what I was, you know, wanting to do today, but right now, I just want eyes on them. I will be very careful, but I'm gonna be walking through this part of the pasture. I think they're over here in the corner. They're in the trees or something. So let's go find these longhorns. I just need eyes on them, on all four of them. And then I can worry about the rest later today. Do-do-do. Just trudging through the Forbes. Do-do-do. That's what I mean, like, you know. What if Tex was laying down just like 10 feet over there? He'd get up and charge me. Also, kind of wish I'd grabbed a fishing pole. So right now, I am stopping every 20 feet or so and listening to see if I can hear them. Oh man, spiderweb right in the face. No sign of them yet. But hey, we got firewood. This is actually really interesting to me. So we got some poop, and it's been scratched through like a chicken would, but our chickens don't come over here. They stay real close to the house. So I wonder what would be doing that. All right. Got evidence. These are longhorn prints, tracks, longhorn tracks, not bison tracks. So I know they walked through here not too long ago. But where to? I do not know. Oh, goodness. Okay, well, there's about one spot left for them to be. And obviously, I really hope that's where they are, because I've covered the north end, covered the south end because there's not trees and you can just see. And I drove over there already. Let's see. Yep, those are more longhorn tracks. Okay, I see them. They circled me. That's funny. Unless those are bison on the other side. I gave them pumpkins earlier. Big old spire just about dropped on my head. Okay, let's be real careful, because I don't know if that was them or not that I saw. I still can't tell because some trees Sorry, I know this is riveting, riveting, entertaining YouTube content. Trying to find longhorns. I've always liked this tree, by the way. It's a really cool tree, all by itself. Don't know what kind of tree it is, because I'm terrible at trees. I am no arborist, by any means. That's what a tree person is, right? An arborist? Okay. Well, let's keep looking. Da 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 da. There's the longhorns. There we go. Man, them chumps. Actually, the real chump is me. Because I did not fix that part of the fence. But it got me thinking. What if I just put a gate right there? Let's cut the fence. What's left of the fence in that spot. And let's just put a gate right there. And that'll be a good spot to rotational move right there. Because when I move the bison, if I'm going like clockwise, counterclockwise, no, clock, yeah, counterclockwise, for instance, then they'll be coming off one of the north pastures. They can go right into that, and then boom, south, right into the northwest corner of the south 40. So yeah, let's do that. I'm just gonna put a gate in. And there we go, there we go. Solution, solution. So all this came about to me to figure out, hey, I should just put a gate there. Because right now, it's like two lines. I feel like I'm about to puke. But got the longhorns back where they're supposed to be. They were, definitely thought I had some cubes. I was shaking a fermented alfalfa bag. Got them coming from right there. So last night, let me flip this around. So yesterday, afternoon and evening, me, Scott, and Thomas fixed a little part on the tractor, and then we kind of stuck up these panels. So we got three really long ones, because this whole line is just really short right here. It's a terrible fence. And we put a gate in. Very rudimentary, simple. I mean, it's just, there's not even hinges. It's baling wire. We cut the fence, what was left of it. Got it wrapped around out of the way so they won't get hung up in it. And then put this gate in. Well, after that, obviously our goal was to get the longhorns. And they were on the far south end, interested in a lot of black Angus. And they would not follow us. So, this morning, I went to a Tuesday mornings. I always have a Bible study with some guys at a coffee shop. I came back home, and I noticed that they were up in this corner. So I ran down here real quick and started shaking that bag. And man, they came running. So I had to sprint all the way. And I know it's not far, but I don't do any type of cardio. So I had to sprint from there to there, shake the bag. They come through the gate, hot and heavy. And I had to just throw the bag and then climb the panel and jump the fence. And so now he's sitting there thinking, hey, I want to go back over there. Well, too bad, so sad, sir. You are back where you belong, and I hope you stay. Please don't try to test the gate. Please don't try to test the gate. Which he is a gate tester, so hopefully it's fine. We did some double strand horse wire as the quote unquote hinge. So, okay, well, my job this morning is done. I will now go to work. All right, see you, everybody.